Welcome to the continued coverage of the Final Fantasy XIV storylines, a passion project for me, right here at the Comic Storian channel, where we take the lore to your favorite video games, comic books, and movies, and we break them down into audio dramas, allowing you to keep up to date on some of your favorite pop culture elements so that you can know what's going on all the time. Now, if you're watching this and you're a fan of Final Fantasy XIV, this video is coming out the day that Shadowbringers is dropping, and I am going to be streaming on our Twitch channel, twitch.tv/eligiblemonster, for the next 3 days, 10-hour streams, starting early morning, going into the evening, giving away various copies of the game itself, Shadowbringers, giving away Mog Station items, giving away stuff to allow you to enjoy this game. And if you just want to keep me company and you're not a fan of Final Fantasy XIV, we've also got Steam cards for you. So come on over to twitch.tv/eligiblemonster and join me. Now, the storyline of the Binding Coil of Bahamut is my favorite raid-based storyline. And this storyline is going to answer the question of what happened in the world of Final Fantasy XIV. Now, for those of you guys who don't know, 1.0 was the original launch of the game, and they relaunched the game as 2.0. When the game relaunched, they didn't just forget everything that had happened in 1.0. There was an epic battle against the Garlean Empire that resolved with Bahamut being summoned. And then Louis Soi teleported all of our heroes 5 years into the future, where we discovered Bahamut was sealed once again. But the question remained, what happened after we left the battlefield? What happened when we were teleported into the future? Well, his grandchildren, Alize and Alphano, went on a journey with the Warrior of Light in the Raid series of 2.0 to discover that very question. And now, we begin our story. The battle has ended, and for a time, the Garlean Empire has been defeated. With the city-states having formed into the Alliance, the Seventh Astral Age has been declared. It is then that Alize, twin sister of Alphano, approached the Warrior of Light and their party. She wished them to aid her in discovering the fate of her grandfather, Louis Soi, who was lost in the final battle of the Primal Bahamut, the ancient deity that brought about the calamity, causing mass destruction across the planet. The group discovered a piece of Dalamund, one of the artificial moons that had orbited Hydaelyn. Within, they discover one of Bahamut's wings, surrounded by corrupted crystals. The group must fight past the automated defense systems, descending into the ancient starship, until they discover the Hand of Bahamut and the fearsome dragon Twintania, who had been enslaved by the ancient race, the Allegans, long ago, before any recorded history. Though the fight was fierce, the Warrior of Light was able to defeat the beast and managed to shut down the Binding Coil of Bahamut, which was allowing the primal deity to slowly restore its body. Knowing that Bahamut's return looms ahead, the warrior and his allies venture to shut down the second coil of Bahamut, traveling to the Northern Shroud, where they're attacked by the fearsome beast known as Rafflesia, which guards the entrance to the second coil. With the creature defeated, the party moves inside, and it is there that they are greeted by White Raven, Nail von Donis, who has been taken as a vessel for Bahamut's influence. The White Raven warns the party against venturing further into the second coil, that should they do so, he would be forced to stop them. With these words, the White Raven disappears into the second coil. Ignoring the warning, the party continues on, fighting their way deeper and lower into the great structure. And finally, the adventurers arrive at the central decks, a maze created by the Allegans and guarded by their machines. Fighting their way to the bottom level of the second coil, our party once again meets the White Raven. After a great battle, the White Raven seems to be released from the hold that Bahamut had over her. And upon learning that Alize is the granddaughter of Louis Soi, she warns her about continuing forward. The truth of what happened may weigh despair upon her. Suddenly, a spear of pure light impales the White Raven, killing her. And Alize is shocked to hear a voice that she knows all too well speak from the shadows, condemning him for his betrayal. Finally, the party arrives in the control room to shut down the second coil, and it is there that they are attacked by none other than Alize's grandfather, Louis Soi. The man comes forward, warning the heroes against interfering with his master plan. There's a brief fight, and it is revealed that Louis Soi also seems to have been overtaken by the influence of Bahamut. Though Alize vows to save her grandfather, the man disappears, as it appears that in the end, in the final battle, Louis Soi lost. Now more determined than ever to stop the return of Bahamut and rescue her grandfather, Alize and the warrior move quickly down to shut down the final coil. Upon entering, they discover that Bahamut's endless return is powered by elegant technology that keeps several devices locked in stasis that will continually summon the massive worm. Deeper within, the group is once again confronted by Louis Soa, who tells them the origins of Bahamut, the once powerful primal who was imprisoned by the Elegans when he was summoned in the defense of their battle. Now controlled by Bahamut's influence, Louis Soa believes that for the dragons to know peace, mankind must be destroyed. Louis Soa reveals his own primal form, transforming into the Phoenix to fight the party. And upon his defeat, Bahamut's influence is released. Louis Soa is himself once again. His mind now clear of Bahamut, he explains the final battle. The Aether mixed with the prayers of the Eorzeans, fusing him with the power of the Primal, allowing him to stop Bahamut and end his destruction before it could spread. Yet Bahamut could not fully be destroyed, and the Primal's very will seized Louis Soa. With the fall of Dalamund, the Elegant structure worked to restore the beast, and now Louis Soa stops the restoration process. And before he disappears, he spends his final moments with his grandchildren. Now the party must stop the final restoration process of the Primal and head into the Burning Hands to confront Bahamut's essence. With his final victory, the warriors return once more to Northern Thanalan. The twins Alphino and Alize agreed that the truth of their grandfather's fate would remain secret, lest the people of Eorzea try to summon him as a Primal as well. Alphino works alongside the Warrior of Light, continuing to try and bring peace to the land, while Alize begins to travel through the lands, hoping to find the path to her own fate. And that is the storyline for The Binding Coil of Bahamut, an amazing finale to Louis Soa and the original storyline of Final Fantasy XIV. Now, for those of you who are just joining us for the first time, or for those who have been here on Comic Storying for a while, I do stream Final Fantasy XIV on quite a few days over at twitch.tv/eligiblemonster. But with the celebration of Shadowbringers finally being released, or at least early access, I'm giving away a lot of stuff over there if you come and join us for these 8 to 12 hour streams that we are pulling off for Friday, Saturday, Sunday this weekend. Now don't worry, we're already working on the next raid. We're going to explain the Crystal Tower storyline, and then we're going to explain probably the Alexander storyline and maybe some of the storylines related, and then we're going to explain some of the class storylines, job storylines. We're going to be talking about the Rabanastra storyline and various things that go on within Final Fantasy XIV. This is a fun passion project for me and Kevin, our editor, who's working on this, as we play way too much of this game already. And I hope you guys are enjoying it as much as we are. If you're curious about the other games we're going to begin to cover, we are about to start working on Castlevania, Devil May Cry, and Assassin's Creed. Assassin's Creed is getting pushed back just a little, only for the simple fact of the matter of they didn't announce a new one, which is what we were planning for. So we're not really rushing to get that out anymore. But I think you guys will enjoy Devil May Cry, Castlevania, and even God of War, which is also in the works. Either way, stick around to the channel. We are tending to cover some video game lore on a weekly basis, along with the various comic books related to these franchises, and I hope you enjoy it as much as I do. Thank you for your support in the never-ending struggle that is YouTube, and I'll see you next week right here, or tomorrow if you enjoy comics.